Kia ora koutou. Please have a seat. In the rangatira, in the whānau, why my name, ki te tautoko, I te kaupapa o te rā, a rā, tātou tamariki, kia ora koutou. Nā mai, hoki mai ki te kia ora nei, he mihi nunui kia koutou. So it's my job this morning. Please do sit down because we're having an informal occasion. It's my job this morning to do some welcomes, some official welcomes and thank yous. And our first welcome has to be to our Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Mr. Key, and our lowest member of Parliament, the Honourable Mr. There are some other people that I would really like to welcome this morning and acknowledge for the part they've played in helping us achieve these new buildings. So first of all, Jared Lane, who's our architect from AP Design, who's managed to take our pictures out of our head and put them onto paper. Our building team from McIntosh Builders and Institution, particularly John and Headley, for taking those pictures and turning them into our buildings. And our project manager, William Woodcroft, who's taking more phone calls than he possibly ever really wanted to take, and for coordinating the whole event. Among our representatives from the Ministry of Education, I particularly want to acknowledge Karen Madden, our property advisor, and Simon Cruikshank for the role that he has played in supporting us in getting these buildings and for listening to us several years ago when we said we're getting a little bit squashed with that we need a new classroom. I also want to thank the members of the Board of Trustees for doing their homework on what modern learning is all about and for their commitment to providing us all with what we think is the best of both worlds, a typical country school experience in an increasingly modern learning environment. Two other thank yous to our caretaker Craig, I'm not sure where Craig is hiding, for keeping our site running while we were a building site and taking such good care of our grounds. And I need to thank all of you for being very adaptable and very accepting when you haven't had a classroom to work in and when things have got a little bit squishy and you've had to pack up and shift several times and you and your teachers have just kept smiling and learning, and we really, really appreciate that. That's me done. I'm going to hand over to our senior students for the official part of the day.
We would like to tell you a story about the little school that grew. Once upon a time, a long time ago, 146 years ago, to be exact, a little school was opened in a little country town. The little country school had one classroom, one teacher, and just 25 children. People in the district heard that a school had opened in Springston and decided to send their children. So, the little school grew.
In 1877, education in the district became compulsory and the little school grew. So in 1898, a second classroom was added.
The boys and girls were not allowed to play together. The girls had played in the school grounds and the boys had to play in the school across a paddock across the road. You could expect to get the strap for having more than two sums wrong or more than two spelling mistakes. Still, the little school grew.
By 1903, there were 101 children on the roll. In 1922, electricity came to the school and the little school grew. In 1927, the little school got its first telephone.
Young men who had been to the little school went off to fight in big wars. Many did not come home. In 1945, both Springston South and Ellesmere schools closed, and the little school stood firm.
By 1956, the little school had grown so much that a new school was needed, and the little school moved to this site. And the rooms that are now our library and room 7 were built. And the little school grew.
In 1962, room 8 was built. In 1973, room 3 arrived. In 1981, the school had grown so much that rooms 1 and 2 were shifted here from Oakland School. There were 115 children in the school. Then, the little school grew.
So in 1985, rooms 5 and 6 were shifted from Shirley Primary School. And finally, in 2003, room 4 was shifted to the school. The little school had 7 classrooms and about 170 children. Then, the little school stood still.
In February 2011, the ground rumbled and buildings tumbled, but the little school stood strong. Soon, children from the damaged lands started arriving at the little school, and the little school really grew.
In 2013, a tiny school just down the road from the little school was closed, and so the little school grew some more.
The children from the little school gathered to watch the opening of the first new and the first permanent classrooms to be built in the little school in 58 years.
And so, the 240 children from the not-so-little school lived happily ever after, while the not-so-little school grew. The end for now.
We would now like to invite our Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Mr. Key, to address our community and then officially open our classrooms.
Can you hear me okay? Yes. Okay, don't need the microphone then. Mr. Sweet, firstly, can I just acknowledge you and all teaching staff at Springston, and thank you for the great work that you do for shaping the minds of our fine young boys and girls that are here today. Amy, can I just acknowledge you for the great work that you do, and also your board of trustees, so it's great to see you. Firstly, you guys are sitting beautifully, aren't you? Yeah, you're in great shape. Are you all excited about the Easter Bunny coming this weekend? Yeah! Sorry, if I don't, that'd be nice. Your Kapa Haka group, by the way, is on the way in. Have you been practicing for long?
Yeah!
Well, you've done a really good job. You've been very proud of yourselves. I think you did a fantastic job. I'm sorry we're a little bit late. Our plane broke down a bit on the tarmac this morning, so we just got a little bit delayed today. But anyway, those things happen, don't they? But we were really pleased to come out and do a few things, which was firstly have a look at your new classrooms, which are really beautiful. And I don't think you really are a little school anymore, are you? You're almost a middle school, basically, and maybe be a good school. So it's a nice story of what you're doing. And so we want to do that. And the second thing is, I know that you're an Enviro school, and I know that you've been doing lots of great work around that. So congratulations. So it's good to learn about your environment, isn't it? About growing things, and it's always fun. Have you got a secret garden, is that true?
Down the back.
And are there lots of secrets in your secret garden?
No.
Well, we all know them, they won't be secrets, don't they? Okay, so anyway, I've done something. That's nice. So thank you for being out here. And we know that your school's going to continue to grow because Christchurch is growing a lot, but make sure you have a great day. And maybe I should just finish before I do this by telling you a bit of the stories you take up here at Easter weekend. So this story is set a long, long time ago, okay, back in what's called medieval times, okay, so it's a long time ago. And the story involves a very rich man who had two things he loved, okay? So the first thing he loved was his daughter, right? And our daughter is 21 tomorrow, and we love her a lot, so that's not unusual that he loved his daughter. But the second thing that he loved was he loved to keep crocodiles in a swimming pool. It's a bit odd, isn't it? So, can you put up your hand for me if you've ever been in a swimming pool? Okay, pretty much all of you. Can you put up your hand for me if you've ever been in a swimming pool and seen crocodiles in it? Okay, this is how the story goes. So back in the day, when the daughter turned 21, it's not unusual, when daughters and sons turn 21, often mum and dad will have a big party. So what they did was, the very rich man decided to have a party for his daughter, and invited all boys that lived in the local area, and when the clock struck midnight, he said to the boys, okay, you guys come with me, He took them down to the outside to where the swimming pool was that was full of crocodiles. So it was a really big pool. It was from about, I'd say, that wall over there, okay, all the way to that wall over there, right? So it's huge, right? And lots of crocodiles. Huh?
No.
So he said, okay, here's the deal. If any boy can swim from one end of the swimming pool to the other, they either get $1 million in cash, the money, right? Or they get to marry my daughter. Quite nice. So anyway, that's a big splash. One of the boys comes in, so he starts swimming along, and the crocodiles start biting and ripping and stuff at them. I won't go into too many details. So basically, they're ripping away, and he's swimming away, and he gets out the other end, and there's sort of blood and all this and stuff, and his clothes were ripped. But the rich man went up to him and said, wow, that's amazing. I never thought anyone could swim from one end of the swimming pool to the other and make it out alive. So, he said, you've got a choice. You can have $1 million in cash, or you can marry the daughter. So if you think you took the money, can you put up your hand? Okay, so if you think you married the daughter, can you put up your hand? Okay, there's an awful lot of love in Springston. Okay, so the answer was, the money or the married the daughter, right? You know what he wanted? The name of the person who pushed him in the swimming pool. Why do I tell you that story? Well, because the rich man and the boy actually ended up going in the water. Never thought he could swim from one end of the swimming pool to the other, right? And you might not think that you can do amazing things. You might not be sure of what you know or what you can't do, but I reckon if you try really hard for mum and dad, and you're really hard for your teachers, and you're really good when you're at school, you can do anything you want to be. So you might want to be prime minister, or you might want to be a nurse, or a doctor, or a teacher, or an airline pilot. Make sure you're ready for mum and dad over Easter. Off to bed quietly. No late night. Don't get too hyped up on all the chocolate, okay?
Thank you, Joe. I'm going to cut the ribbon. We're here, you're going over.
We're inside.
Can you just do me a favor, can you see, what's your name? Rob, can you just turn around and see that camera there? Can you just do that for a second?
Thank you all very much for being part of this special day. Unfortunately, we won't be able to plant our tree until next term, but Georgia Watkin has a message for you all from the catering team.
Because of our special day, we have a little treat for each child. A box of cupcakes will be given to each teacher for their class. On behalf of the catering team, I would like to thank the parents who made the cupcakes and to Gillian, our school cleaner, for making the decorations. Please enjoy.